Welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to start our discussion on gymnosperms. Okay, so gymnosperms is formed up of two words. The one is gymno and the next one is sperms. So it simply means naked seeds, yani ki the seeds which are not covered with an envelope. So agar definition ki baat kari jaye, to ovules are naked. They are not covered with any ovary wall before or after fertilization. कहने का मतलब ये है कि ovules जो कि आगे चल के seed बनाएंगे वो covered नहीं होते, right? So ovules are not covered by ovary wall both before and after fertilization. That's clear from the name itself, gymnosperms. Okay, so कोई अगर आपसे पूछ ले तो नाम में ही answer है. Gymno means naked and sperms means seeds. After that, what do the gymnosperms contain? Gymnosperms में क्या हो सकते हैं? They may contain shrubs. We know very well about herbs, shrubs and trees. So the shrubs and bushes can be a part of gymnosperms, but they are very few. Most of the members are of gymnosperms are medium to large sized trees. बहुत ही बड़े-बड़े trees भी हो सकते हैं. For example, the redwood tree, that is Sequoia gigantica. Okay, Sequoia gigantica, अगर आप पूरा नाम लिखना चाहते हैं तो this is one of the largest species known in gymnosperms. Okay, Sequoia or the redwood tree is very large in height, and obviously if it is very large or even if it is medium sized tree, it would be having tap root arrangement. So the root is probably tap root, and there are some other functions of roots too. The roots can form different kind of associations. If the root is associated with fungal elements, यानी कि अगर वो fungus के साथ associated है, fungi के साथ associated है, then it will be known as mycorrhiza, right? And the example is pinus. It means that the plant pinus roots will be associated with fungus, and this association is known as mycorrhiza. In case of cycas, there is another special association known as coralloid roots. So C for cycas, C for coralloid roots, which is the association of roots of cycas with BGA, which are also known as cyanobacteria, which are nitrogen fixation doing bacteria. So they used to fix nitrogen. So there are three C in the name itself. The first C is for coralloid roots. The second C is for cycas, because cycas ki roots ko hum use karenge. The third one is cyanobacteria, which are also known as blue-green algae. These are photosynthetic in nature and they can also fix nitrogen, jis purpose ki wajah se ye association banti hai, right? So the first thing is the seeds will be naked, then they will be containing shrubs, medium to large sized trees. The largest tree is Sequoia in the gymnosperms. After that, they are having tap root arrangement, and the root can form different kind of associations such as mycorrhiza or coralloid roots. Mycorrhiza kaun banayega? Pinus. Coralloid roots, cycas, because C for cycas, C for coralloid, C for cyanobacteria. Right? I hope yahan tak sab clear hai. After that, there can be branching. The stems can be branched or unbranched. So if stems are branched, they can be in some higher plants such as pinus and cedrus. Or if they are not branched, they are straight, then it can be cycas. So these examples are also very important, that the stem can be branched in pinus and cedrus, and it can be unbranched in case of cycas, where pinnately leaves present for very long time and even for some years. So pinnate leaves kya hoti hai yahan par? They will be having a common axis, and there will be leaves on both the side, right? And there will be a terminal leaflet. This is the pinnate leaf. So such kind of leaves may be present in cycas. So the stem can be unbranched as in cycas. It can be branched in case of pinus and cedrus. Each and every example really means a lot. Okay? Aur uska jo examination point of view se importance hai bahut zyada hai, because the systematics is all about examples, right? In biological classification, in plant kingdom, in animal kingdom, in morphology, in anatomy, You have to memorize each and every example. And in the seventh chapter, structural organization, the examples of tissues are very, very important. So most of the questions from these seven chapters are totally based on examples. If you are able to memorize each and every example in your mind, then you can get even 30-40 marks from just memorizing the examples. We will be learning fifth chapter, that is morphology of flowering plants. It is totally example based chapter. There will be no definition which is going to be asked. There are only just examples. And hundreds of examples you have to remember with different kind of tricks. Okay? So, unbranched in cycas and branched in pinus and cetus. Now, there are some plants called conifers. They are cone shaped, that's why known as conifers. Unme kuch special properties hoti hain. Kyunki wo aisi jagah par paaye jaate hain jahan par water kafi kam hota hai. If the water is less, it means that they are absorbing less water. Yani ki unhe water ab conserve karna hai, so the loss of water must be reduced. So water ko bachane ke liye, water ke loss ko bachane ke liye, they used to apply some mechanisms on themselves and there are some adaptations. The first adaptation is needle-like leaf. If the leaf is broad, then it will be having a larger surface area. If the surface area is larger, there will be maximum number of stomata, there will be very huge amount of transpiration, huge water loss. But if it is needle shaped, the surface area will be small, there will be less surface area, so less loss of water. There will be thick cuticle and sunken stomata, which are also very important adaptations to decrease the loss of water. Okay, thick cuticle hoga to usko पेनिट्रेट कर पाना मतलब बहुत मुश्किल हो जाएगा, तो वो थिक लेयर जो है वाटर के लॉस को प्रिवेंट करती है. और स्टोमेटा संकर होंगे तो ऑब्वियसली क्या होगा, ट्रांसपिरेशन कम होगी. नाउ दीज आर हेट्रोस्पोरस. इन केस ऑफ टेरिडोफाइट्स वी हैव टेकन टू एग्जांपल सेलेजिनेला एंड साल्विनिया विच आर हेट्रोस्पोरस विच गिव राइज टू द सीड हैबिट. सिमिलरली देर आर टू डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्पोर्स, द माइक्रो एंड द मैक्रो. And just in case of pteridophyte, it is also same. The micro will be giving rise to male gametophyte and the macro will be giving rise to the female gametophyte. Now, the reproductive events take place which are very, very complex. I mean, you need to memorize each and every term very carefully. Very, very carefully, you need to memorize this topic. You need to revise this topic several times. Otherwise, aap examination mein pakka bhul jayenge. Kyunki kya hai? Problem is not to memorize something or to conceptualize something. The problem here is that the same thing is present in pteridophytes by utilizing different names. There are anthrozoids, there is anthridium, archegonium. In the other category, it is known as male gametophyte, female gametophyte, sporophyte, okay, sporozoa, different kind of thing. मतलब कि आप protozoa में भी confused हो जाएंगे. ऐसी terms हैं जो कि थोड़ी थोड़ी different हैं बाकी सब units से भी. तो आपको ऐसा लगेगा यार ये वहां पड़ा था, ये वहां पड़ा था. सो देयर विल बी अ लॉट ऑफ कॉम्प्लिकेशंस व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी क्रिएटेड बिकॉज़ द नेम्स आर वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. ओके, द स्पोरोफिल इज डिफरेंट थिंग, द माइक्रोस्पोरेंजिया इज अनदर थिंग. ओके, द स्पोरेंजिया इज अनदर थिंग. बहुत सारी ऐसी चीज है जो कि सिमिलर साउंड करेंगी बट उनका मतलब बहुत डिफरेंट होगा. सो आई ट्राई टू कंसेप्चुलाइज इन अ बेटर वे सो दैट यू कैन मेमोराइज इट फॉर वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम बट यू हैव टू रिवाइज. आई एम सेइंग दैट इट on a very large scale, बार बार ये चीज मैं बोल रहा हूँ because it is very important and it is very crucial. यहाँ के question में confusion बहुत होती है. So the male strobili. Now what is strobili? We know very well that pteridophytes में हमने पढ़ा था there will be a sporangium in which spores are present and there are sporophylls. Okay, sporophylls which are leaf-like structure जिन पे जो है sporangium present होता है. And that sporophyll sometimes used to got compact और वो एक cluster बना लेते हैं. That cluster is known as the strobili or cone. Okay? So there are leaf-like structure on which sporangia are present. That leaf-like structure got compact and after that many of these forms a cluster which is known as cone or strobilus. So male strobilus क्या होगा? जिसमें दो चीजें present होंगी. Male sporophyll, okay, sporophyll will be male and sporangia will also be male and male means micro. फीमेल. सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द फीमेल स्ट्रोबिलस, तो हम वहां पर बोलेंगे देयर इज मेगा स्पोरोफिल एंड मेगा स्पोरेंजियम. बट इन केस ऑफ मेल, ओके, इन केस ऑफ मेल स्ट्रोबिलस देयर इज माइक्रोस्पोरेंजिया. ओके, स्पोरेंजिया जो था, जो एनक्लोज हो रहा था, दैट इज माइक्रो, एंड जो लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर थी दैट आर ऑल्सो माइक्रोस्पोरोफिल्स. इन केस ऑफ फीमेल देयर इज मेगा स्पोरेंजिया एंड मेगा स्पोरोफिल्स, राइट. सो ये है मेल स्ट्रोबिलस और मेल कोन या फिर फीमेल स्ट्रोबिलस में डिफरेंस. ओके, कोन हम इसे कह रहे हैं टेरिडोफाइट के रेफरेंस में, क्योंकि वहां पर हमने कोन और स्ट्रोबिलस दोनों चीजें पढ़ी थी. सो मेल कोन और फीमेल कोन की डेफिनेशन में कोई डाउट नहीं है. देयर आर सम माइक्रोस्पोर्स, ऑब्वियसली देयर इज माइक्रोस्पोरेंजिया व्हिच विल बी कंटेनिंग स्पोर्स. दोज माइक्रोस्पोर्स विल बी डेवलप्ड इनटू मेल गैमेटोफाइट. ओके, जो माइक्रोस्पोर्स हैं स्पोरेंजियम के अंदर वो मेल गैमेटोफाइट बनाएंगे विच इज रिड्यूस्ड एंड देर आर वेरी फ्यू नंबर ऑफ सेल्स इन इट विच इज वेरी रिड्यूस्ड. ओके, दैट रिड्यूस्ड गैमेटोफाइट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज पॉलन ग्रेन्स. ओके, नाउ कंसेप्चुलाइज दिस थिंग इन योर माइंड दैट देर इज स्पोरेंजिया. द स्पोरेंजिया इज कंटेनिंग द स्पोर्स और द माइक्रोस्पोर्स. द माइक्रोस्पोर्स आर गेटिंग डेवलप्ड into reduced male gametophyte which is known as pollen grain, right? So where is the pollen grain produced? Obviously in the microsporangia, क्योंकि ये सारी चीजें हम microsporangia में बात कर रहे हैं, right? So the pollen grains will be developed in microsporangia because in microsporangia there are spores. Okay, let's make it, this is microsporangia, let's say. Okay, in this there is some spore. That spore will be getting developed or matured into the male gametophyte, okay, which is quite reduced, and that male gametophyte is known as pollen grain. So pollen grain is also present in the microsporangia, that's obvious. Okay, so is tarike se kya hota hai, pollen grain ka development hota hai. After that pollen grain jayega female gamete ke paas and it will try to fuse with it, and after that it will form zygote as well as seed. So this is the generation of pollen grain inside the microsporangia. Microsporangia ke andar spore hoga, microspore which will develop into reduced male gametophyte known as pollen grain, right? After that there is female strobilus jisme hoga megasporophyll and megasporangium. Inside megasporangium there are also some things which are taking place which will surely form the egg, aur uske baad hoga fusion. After fusion, the zygote formation will be taking place and the seeds are formed. Okay, so we will talk about the further processes in next lecture, because if you will read different kind of terms in a single lecture, then you will surely be getting confused in your examination. So we are separating each and every class into two different lectures. So in the second lecture, we will be completing the gymnosperms. यहाँ पर हमने pollen grain कैसे बनता है ये पता कर लिया. अब next में हम फीमेल गैमेट कैसे बनता है ये पता करेंगे और उसके बाद उनके फ्यूजन के बारे में बात करेंगे. सो आई होप यू गॉट द लेक्चर वेरी वेल. अगर आपको समझ में आया देन डू हिट लाइक बटन, शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स, सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल, एंड देयर आर वेरी क्रूशियल पॉइंट्स इन दिस लेक्चर व्हिच यू हैव टू मेमोराइज. द फर्स्ट वन इज अबाउट सिकोया, द सेकंड इज द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ माइकोराइजा एंड कोरलॉइड रूट्स. दे आर आस्क्ड वेरी टाइम्स, सेवरल टाइम्स ऑलरेडी पूछ लिए जा चुके हैं बहुत बार. इसके बाद कुछ चीजें आती हैं, दैट इज पॉलन ग्रेन्स कहां बनते हैं, राइट. सो दैट आंसर मस्ट बी क्लियर इन योर माइंड फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर. ओके, एंड आफ्टर दैट इन सब चीजों के एग्जांपल्स तो आपको याद करने ही करने. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ जिम्नोस्पर्म्स. इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट एंड द फ्यूजन ऑफ फीमेल एंड मेल गैमेट. थैंक यू सो मच गाइस फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो.